Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to TechnoGenier. I am Dr. Mohammad Yaqub. In this lecture, I will discuss about the fuel cell. Initially, I will discuss the functionality of the fuel cell. Then I will go to its composition and its working principle. And then I will discuss about different types of fuel cell, then its advantages, disadvantages, and how it is used in transportation or energy technologies, and finally how the efficiency of the fuel cell is calculated and what are the methodologies to improve the efficiency of the fuel cell. So first of all, what is fuel cell? A fuel cell is an electrochemical device that converts chemical energy into electrical energy. If you see the diagram, it is simple. A fuel cell is simple, is similar to the batteries. It has two electrodes, one is anode and the second one is cathode. Anode is for the positive side and cathode is for the negative side, and it will take hydrogen as a fuel, and when the hydrogen goes inside, the anode will ionize the hydrogen, and the negative charge of the hydrogen passes from the anode to the cathode by a conduction wire, and due to that conduction, current will flow and electricity is produced. While the hydrogen ion is combined with the oxygen to form water, and the remaining energy is exhausted in the form of heat. So this is the basic functionality of the fuel cell. So if you see, compare it with the conventional combustion engine, then in the combustion engine we take we basically burn the fuel, and then the fuel will produce heat, and that heat will be converted into mechanical energy, and then that mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. While in the fuel cell, there is simple small chemical reaction, and from that chemical reaction, electricity is produced. So the conversion efficiency of the fuel cell is very high as compared to the conversion efficiency of the conventional combustion engine, because there is a loss in converting chemical energy into heat energy, and then converting heat energy into mechanical energy, and then converting mechanical energy into electrical energy. While in the fuel cell, the chemical energy is directly converted into electricity, so the loss is reduced. So if you see the applications of the fuel cell, it can be used in the cars, building power stations, spacecraft, and many other things where we can use battery as a source of energy. It can be replaced with the fuel cell. Fuel cell has many additional advantages compared to the batteries, because the batteries need to be charged after a certain interval. For example, if we put the batteries in a car, in an electric car, then after certain time the battery is discharged and we need to charge it, and its charging required a lot of time. So in the majority of the cases, we consider that the future of the vehicles is basically fuel cell, not the batteries. No doubt the infrastructure which is used in the batteries is will be similar in the fuel cell cars, but in the fuel cell we would have hydrogen as a fuel, and once we fill the hydrogen in the fuel tank, then we have enough energy to move in thousands of kilometers. We do not require to recharge like in the electric vehicle. So major companies in the world, like a famous company like Bollard Power System, General Electric Company, General Motors, Siemens, Toyota, Mazda, Honda, Toshiba, Hitachi, Fuji Electric, Mitsubishi, Ford, Nikola. These are the major companies which are working in the automobiles and the power sector. They are doing research and developing different kinds of automobiles related to the fuel cell. So their focus is to develop fuel cell based automobiles or cars. Even there are some companies which are already developing fuel cell based cars, like Nikola is developing fuel cell based trucks, Similarly, Toyota is developing fuel cell based cars. Similarly, General Electric is using fuel cell as a source of energy. And other companies are also using fuel cell as a source of energy. So basic configuration of the fuels, there are three major parts in a fuel cell. One is anode, second one is cathode, and the middle portion is electrolyte. So this is the similar to the batteries, because in batteries we have anode, we have cathode, and in between anode and cathode we have electrolyte. But in the fuel cell we use hydrogen as an input source and oxygen as an input, while the output would be water and the electricity. So a fuel cell consists of two electrodes, namely anode and cathode, and in between anode and cathode, it is sandwiched around an electrolyte. Electrolyte is a substance, solid or liquid, or capable of conducting owing ion from one electrode to another electrode. So this electrolyte is required to transfer the ions of the hydrogen from anode to cathode. So every fuel cell produce DC current, but the quantity of the DC current is very low. So in order to use the fuel cell as a source of energy, we usually use stacks of cell. In we know you usually use multiple cells in a series or parallel configuration to produce huge amount of electricity. So it produces DC. So in order to consume it in for the AC load, we need inverter to convert this DC into AC in for a useful purpose. So the basic working principle of the fuel cell is it basically take fuel or hydrogen as a source of energy, and there are special material for the anode which do not allow electron to pass through, and it just allow the proton to pass through. So the electron will move toward the conduction path, which will be a wire from the electron to from anode to cathode. That conduction path will transfer the electrons, while the positive charge or the proton will be transferred from the electrolyte, and it will transfer to the cathode. At the cathode, it will have the oxygen, and that oxygen will combine with the ionized hydrogen and electron to form water. And this water composition will produce some heat and energy, and that energy can be converted into electricity. So this is the complete composition of the fuel cell. If you see, there is a in between anode and cathode, there is a proton transport that is known as PEM, that is basically an electrolyte, and for one side is basically anode and the second side is cathode, and in between anode and cathode there is a separate layer which is known as catalyst in order to enhance the reaction procedure. While the free electron will be traveled from the electric path, which is formed in the form of wires and some resistors. So the fuel will be the hydrogen and the oxygen from the air. The hydrogen is entered from the anode, and the oxygen is entered from the cathode. And the useful hydrogen will be converted in an ion form, which is H plus, and the electron will be moved from the electric circuit. And the remaining hydrogen, which is not converted into ionized, can be recycled. And the hydrogen which is consumed will be transferred to the cathode, and from the cathode it will react with the oxygen to form H2O. So the reaction will be half O2 plus 2 H plus 2 electron, it will give H2O. So the output will be water in the form of air or water vapors, and this heat will be converted into electricity. can also be converted into electricity, and the current which flow from anode to cathode is basically the electrical energy which is formed, and the efficiency is 40 to 60%. The remaining efficiency is due to the heat loss. So this is the working principle. The fuel gas hydrogen is passed toward the anode, where the following oxidation reaction occur. The H2 is converted into 2H plus plus 2 electron. The liberated electron from the hydrogen in anode side do not migrated through the electrolyte. The free electron they passes through the external circuit where work is performed. The finally goes into the cathode. On the other hand, the positive side of the hydrogen will migrated through the electrolyte to the cathode. And from at the cathode side, the hydrogen atom react with the oxygen and electron to form water as a byproduct. According to the chemical reaction, this is the complete chemical reaction. H2 plus half O2 plus 2 electrons is equal to H2O plus heat. So this is the complete phenomenon. So if you see, this is the complete fuel cell, and this is the basic phenomenon of the fuel cell. Hydrogen is an input and oxygen is an input, and from the hydrogen and oxygen, free charge will be moved from the circuit, and hydrogen react with the oxygen to form water, and water will be the output. Normally, a single fuel cell will not produce a huge amount of electricity. So we will combine multiple fuel cell in the form of stack to produce huge amount of electricity. So this is basically the structure of a multi-cell stack in which multiple fuel cells are connected in series formation to produce huge amount of electricity. So there are multiple types of the fuel cell. The common types are alkaline fuel cell, direct methanol fuel cell, molten carbonate fuel cell, phosphoric acid fuel cell, polymer electrolyte membrane fuel cell, and then solid oxide fuel cell. And these are the abbreviation like alkaline AFC and direct methanol DMFC. So these are the abbreviations of the different types of fuel cell. So these are the chemical reaction. If you see the table, this is PEM fuel cell, and PEM fuel cell is basically polymer electrolyte membrane, and the electrolyte is basically solid organic polymer, and its operating temperature is 30 to 80 degree. Anode reaction is H2 to 2H plus 2 electron, while the cathode reaction is half O2 plus 2H ion of hydrogen plus electron, which will produce H2O. Similarly, the second one is solid oxide fuel cell, that its electrolyte is solid zirconium oxide, and it works in approximately 600 to 1000 degree centigrade, and the chemical reaction is similar. Then we have phosphoric acid fuel cell. For the phosphoric acid fuel cell, the electrolyte is phosphoric acid soaked in a matrix, and its operating temperature is 175 to 200 degree centigrade, and the chemical reaction is the same. Then we have alkaline fuel cell. The electrolyte is aqueous solution of potassium hydroxide soaked in a matrix, and its operating temperature is 90 to 100, and its chemical reaction is same. Then we have molten carbonate. Its electrolyte is solution of lithium, sodium and potassium carbonate soaked in a matrix. Its operating temperature is 600 to 1000 degree centigrade, and it normally use hydrogen plus carbon dioxide as an input, which is basically CH4, and then it will produce, its output will produce H2O plus CO2 plus 2 electron, and that 2 electron plus carbon dioxide in the cathode side, it will produce CO3, and the hydrogen plus half O2 plus CO2 will produce H2O plus carbon dioxide. This is the complete reaction of the molten carbonate. So this is the basic composition of the alkaline fuel cell. they operate on a compressed hydrogen and oxygen that generally use a solution of potassium hydroxide in water as an electrolyte. So you see that hydrogen is an input and there is an anode and there is a cathode. The major difference in different types of fuel cell is basically the electrolyte. So for this case, the electrolyte is hydroxyl ion. The second is molten carbonate. It is basically require a high temperature compound of salt like sodium or magnesium carbonate as an electrolyte. So this is, if you see the fuel cell, the electrolyte is carbon trioxide ion. Its efficiency range is from 60 to 80%, while its operating temperature is 650 degrees centigrade. And the third one is phosphoric acid fuel cell. The energy it is basically initiated in 1970 at Los Alamos National Laboratory. The major objective is to convert the electric vehicle into specifically for the golf cart, to convert it to a fuel cell based car. And the basic working principle is it will use phosphoric acid fuel, which its percentage average is almost 40 to 50%, and it produces heat as a waste. And if we generate that heat into electricity, then its overall efficiency is approximately 80%. So this is the basic composition of phosphoric acid fuel cell. In between this, the electrolyte is basically a phosphoric acid. Then we have solid oxide fuel cell, and solid oxide fuel cell uses a hard ceramic compound of metals such as calcium oxide or zirconium oxide as an electrolyte. The solid electrolyte is coated on both sides with a specialized porous electrode material. The cell efficiency is 60%, while the operating temperature is approximately 1000 degrees centigrade. So this is basic phenomena. In this, this cell is totally different than remaining cell because it uses oxygen as an ion, and it produces the chemical reaction. The hydrogen will directly combine with oxygen ion to form water and electricity. Similarly, the last one is proton exchange membrane. It is the common type of the fuel cell, which is mostly used because its operating temperature is normal temperature compared to the other fuel cell, because in other fuel cell we need to warm up the fuel cell. So in some fuel cell operating temperature is 100 degree, or other fuel cell operating temperature is 600 degree centigrade. So the operation cost is very expensive, and in order to produce that temperature we need additional source. But in the PEM fuel cell, it normally works in the room temperature, so it is the most useful fuel cell. And it is the common fuel cell which is used. So the PEM fuel cell uses an advanced plastic electrolyte in the form of thin preamble sheet to exchange proton from the anode to the cathode. So the center membrane is basically called as proton exchange membrane. And there are two types of PEM fuel cell. One is hydrogen fuel cell, and the second one is direct methanol fuel cell. Both use PEM as an electrolyte, which transport the hydrogen ion from the anode to the cathode. So this is the basic composition of the PEM fuel cell. The electrolyte material is specifically a PEM type material, which allow the proton to pass, and it does not allow the electron to pass, and the electron pass through the electrical circuit of the system. So this is the composition. There are two types of PEM fuel cell. One is hydrogen fuel cell, and the second one is direct methanol. This is the hydrogen fuel cell, and this is the direct methanol. We take methanol as an input. and it will produce CH3OH plus hydrogen ion, and then we take air as an input, which will take oxygen, and this oxygen will react with the hydrogen to produce water and CO2. So this is basic phenomena of ethanol type fuel cell. So the basic advantage of fuel cell is basically it is zero emission. So the fuel cell, majority of the fuel cell do not emit any harmful gases, like in combustion engine, carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide it produce. While in the fuel cell, the output is usually water, and this water is a drinkable water. So we do not need any compensatory devices which can remove the pollution, because it does not produce any air pollution. The second advantage is high efficiency. Fuel cell convert chemical energy into electrical energy without the combustion process. So the overall efficiency of the fuel cell compared to the efficiency of the combustion is very high. The third point is high power density. A high power density allow fuel cell to relatively compact source of electric power, beneficial in different kind of applications, specifically in electric vehicles. The fourth point is quiet operation, because there is no mechanical composition or mechanical mechanism. So the fuel cell produces electricity without any noise, and it will not produce any kind of noise pollution. The fifth point is no charging, because in batteries, the major issues of the battery is to charge, and usually a good battery would require 4 to 5 hours to charge. So otherwise we need special kind of chargers to charge battery as early as possible. Normally the minimum time required to charge the battery is 30 minutes to 1 hour, but if we use fast chargers, it would damage the battery. But in case of fuel cell, we do not require to charge. We just need hydrogen as a fuel, which can be injected in the cylinder, and that cylinder will act as a source. So we do not need to charge the fuel cell. So it is an extraordinary replacement of the batteries, because the battery's life is approximately, it would take some time to charge, and then it will take after certain kilometer it will completely discharge, and then we need to charge it again. But for the fuel cell, once we fill the tank, then it works similar to the cars which are already being used. So the disadvantage of the fuel cell is it is difficult to manufacture, and it requires a huge amount of hydrogen which is not produced. So we need some chemical reaction to produce hydrogen. So that's why it is very expensive as compared to the batteries. That's why it cannot be used as a replacement of the battery. But once the fuel cell technology is matured, or the quality of the fuel cell is improved, then it will be a best solution to replace the battery and convert the overall vehicles into fuel cell. These are the major type of commonly used fuel cell type trucks. There are two companies which are developing trucks on the fuel cell. One is Hyundai, and the second one is basically Nikola. They are developing fuel cell based trucks. However, there are some companies which are developing fuel cell based buses, and some companies are developing fuel cell based cars, because the technology for the buses and the trucks are similar, and it is easy to convert the buses and the cars, buses, cars and the trucks into the fuel cell based. So the basic circuit diagram of the fuel cell based car is this. There will be a tank which will store hydrogen as a source. Then we have fuel cell stack, where multiple fuel cells are connected in series or parallel in form to produce huge amount of electricity. Then we have special DC to DC converter, which will force the fuel cell to work at the maximum power point. The algorithm which is used in the fuel cell is called maximum power point tracking. Then we have that DC will be provided to the power distribution unit, and that power distribution unit can force the power toward the battery to charge, or it will divert to the inverter to convert this DC into AC, and that AC will be used for the induction motor, which are commonly used in the electric vehicle to run the wheel of the system. So in order to produce hydrogen, it becomes very difficult to produce hydrogen. So there is a process or simpler process which is on an electrolyzer. So we use solar panels or the wind turbine in the remote areas so that these voltages or current which is produced in the solar panel or the wind turbine will be fed to the liquid which basically convert the water into hydrogen. So the process is called electrolyzer process. It will produce hydrogen and oxygen. That hydrogen will be forwarded to the fuel cell, and the fuel cell will convert this hydrogen into ionized form, and that fuel cell will be combined with oxygen to produce electricity, and the remaining byproduct of the fuel cell is water, which is very environmental friendly, and the secondly, this water is drinkable. So the basic thermodynamic of the fuel cell, when we use fuel cell, the chemical reaction is basically exothermic reaction. So these exothermic reaction are instantaneous reaction. It work spontaneously, and hydrogen immediately combined with oxygen to form water. Their eagerness to do so provide the energy that the fuel cell uses to deliver electric energy to the load. So this is the basic chemical action, which I already told you that H2 will produce 2H plus plus 2 electron, and then 2H plus will combine with oxygen to form H2O. So this is the basic mathematical equation of the fuel cell. While for the fuel cell in thermodynamic conversion, we need to understand the three topologies. One is enthalpy, second one is free energy, and the third one is entropy. So these are the three terminologies which we need to understand, which I will discuss in the next lecture. Thank you. Jazakallah. Hopefully you understand the complete lecture. If you have any query or questions, you can contact me on this YouTube channel, or you can SMS me. Stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.